Hello guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to generate PWM signal with 555 timer IC, and also I'll explain the calculation of the PWM signal. So let's get started. The generation of PWM signal is only possible in the Astable mode. In the last video, I have shown the Astable mode with the internal circuit. As you know, in the Astable mode, a resistor is connected between pin number 7 and 8, and another resistor is connected between 6 and 7. It is also connected to pin number 2. And then one capacitor is connected to ground. This one C, this one RA, and this one RB, according to the last video. So these three devices will decide the frequency and the duty cycle of the output. And here we are going to supply plus 5 volt. Okay. So before going to the circuit diagram, we need to know the output waveform and the duty cycle. So as we know, the output will be like this, and here is the one cycle from here to here, okay, and this is in time, and this part we call it T on, and this part we call it T off. So by changing the T on and T off, we can increase or decrease the duty cycle. Let's see another waveform. See here, T on is very small, but T off is very large. Okay, so this is one cycle, this is another cycle, and this can be in other way, like this. Here the T off is very small, but T on is very large. Here we can see it is approximately 50% of duty cycle, because 50% is on and 50% is off. Here we can say it is 10% T on and 90% T off. So its duty cycle is 10%, because we consider only the T on time. So it is 10%. But here if we consider, so it is approximately 90% on time and 10% off time. Okay. Now see the connection. Pin number 8 goes to plus VCC. 4 is connected to plus VCC. Pin number 1 is connected to ground. Pin number 5 is connected with a 0.01 microfarad capacitor. Then it goes to ground. Okay, so these are the common connection. Now for the Astable mode connection, we need to connect pin number 6 and 2. I'm connecting 1 kilo ohm resistor between pin number 7 and 8. Okay, and 10 kilo ohm resistor between 7 and 6 and 2, and 47 microfarad capacitor is between pin number 2 and the ground. So these three devices will decide the duty cycle. So this one RA, RB and C. Now connect the output. Okay, now let's calculate T on and T off. In the last video, I have shown the two equations. T on is equal to 0.693 multiplied by RA plus RB multiplied by C, and T off equal to 0.693 multiplied by RB multiplied by C. Now see this, as here RA equal to 1 kilo ohm and RB equal to 10 kilo ohm and C equal to 47 microfarad. So I am writing here RA equal to 1 kilo ohm, RB equal to 10 kilo ohm and C equal to 47 microfarad. T on equal to 693 multiplied by RA plus RB, that is 11,000 ohms multiplied by 47 microfarad. Microfarad means 10 to the power minus 6 farad. So 47, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? Because we can write 10 to the power minus 6 equal to 1 by 10 to the power 6. So this is what I am writing here. Okay? And its unit will be second. 3030. Now we have 693, 11, 47 by 1000 second. By calculating it, we are getting 0.358 second. We can write it as 358 millisecond. Okay, so this is our T on. Now calculate the T off. T off equal to 0.693 multiplied by only RB, so 10,000 multiplied by C, that is 47 microfarad. 10,000 47 by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. 4, 4, 0. 6, 9, 3, 47 by 100. We are getting it as 0.325 second. We can write it as 325 millisecond. Okay. This is our T off. Now let's see whether our value is correct or not. I am writing here T of value, it was 325 millisecond. Okay, now see, here I am connecting the power supply, positive and negative. Okay, now I am connecting my oscilloscope here, ground, and the output pin, that is pin number 3. See here, it is showing here 350 millisecond. Now selecting the cursor. Okay. Here T on. It is 350 millisecond. Now for T off, I have to take this to here. Yes. Now it is correct. See, it is exactly 325 millisecond, the T off. In the previous video, I have explained the output waveform T on and T off, and also the input capacitor charging and discharging waveforms. So let's see this. To see the capacitor charging and discharging waveform, we have to connect another oscilloscope probe to positive terminal of the capacitor. So now see this. The blue wave is indicating the capacitor charging and discharging. From this, we can understand that whenever the capacitor charges, the output of the IC is high, and whenever the capacitor is discharging, our output will be low. To get proper PWM signal, we need to decrease the capacitor value for higher frequency. And we need to replace the RB resistor with a potentiometer and with two diodes. Now let's see the circuit diagram. Up to this, it is same as before. This one is RA, this one is C. Now we need to modify RB with two diodes and a potentiometer. We'll connect RB here, and the value is 10 kilo ohm. Okay, now see, we'll connect one diode here and another diode in other way. Okay, now we'll connect these two diodes with a potentiometer, and the middle pin of potentiometer will go to pin number 6 and 2, and the value of the potentiometer is 100 kilo ohms. Okay, so this is all about the modification. Now let's see on the breadboard. Now remove this. We need a lower value capacitor. Now add two diodes here. RB resistor is between two diodes. This end will go to pin number 7. is our potentiometer. This pin is connected to this diode and this side is connected to this diode. Middle pin of potentiometer is connected to pin number 6 and 2. And I am connecting a 100 nanofarad capacitor between pin number 2 and the ground. Now see here, if I rotate the potentiometer, then the brightness of the LED should increase or decrease. Here fully decreased, here it is increased. Okay. Now let's see the waveforms. Here I have connected both the probe, this one for output and this one for the capacitor. Here in the capacitor I have connected this one. Now I am keeping my LED at full brightness. Now see this. The duty cycle is 90.5%, and you can see the on time is very large compared to off time. Okay, now here you can see properly. See this. Now if I rotate, now our duty cycle is 50% and the LED brightness is also decreased by 50%. Again it is decreasing the brightness, so the on time is very small compared to off time. So this is how PWM signal works. See the oscilloscope and the LED. So guys, this is all for today. I hope you like this video. If so, then please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And if you have any doubt on this, then please let me know in the comment section. In the next video, I'll show you the brightness control of an 100 watt electric bulb with 555 IC. Till then, stay happy and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.